Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sweta, working as Associate Professor of Chemistry Department in St. Peter's Engineering College. St. Peter's Engineering College is a UGC autonomous institution located in Mysamma-Goda near Kumpalli. Now coming to today's talk is on molecular orbital diagrams. This is one of the topic in the first unit of engineering chemistry syllabus named as Molecular Structure and Theories of Bonding. In the Unit 1 first session, we have discussed about the molecular orbital theory and linear combination of atomic orbitals. So today's talk is on molecular orbital diagrams as an extension of molecular orbital theory. So in the molecular orbital theory, during the formation of molecule, the atoms will combine together to form the molecule. In the same way, the atomic orbitals of two atoms will undergo linear combination to form the molecular orbitals. And if they are formed by the additive effect, the formed molecular orbitals are known as the bonding molecular orbitals, and which are having the lower energy than the atomic orbitals. Whereas if the atomic orbitals will undergo destructive effect, the wave function of the atomic orbitals will undergo destructive effect, then the formed molecular orbitals are known as the anti-bonding molecular orbitals, and they will be represented with the star, and they are having high energy than that of the atomic orbitals. So the number of atomic orbitals participated in the overlapping is equals to the number of molecular orbitals are formed. Like how many number of atomic orbitals will combine to form the molecular orbitals, that many number of molecular orbitals are formed. For example, if we take the hydrogen molecule, 1s orbital of two hydrogen atoms will combine together or undergoes linear combination of atomic orbital to form bonding molecular orbital and antibonding molecular orbital. The sigma 1s is the bonding molecular orbital which is having the lower energy, whereas sigma star 1s, this is the antibonding molecular orbital and having the higher energy. So this is about the molecular orbital of 1s atomic orbitals. Now coming to the different molecular orbitals which are formed by the combination of different kinds of atomic orbitals, here we can see. Like filling up of the atomic orbitals will follow Afbau principle like in the atomic orbitals. In the same way, if we consider the increasing order of the energy of molecular orbitals, electrons will be first filled in the lowest energy orbital. And this energy levels will be different for hydrogen to nitrogen, one set of increasing order of molecular orbitals. Whereas from oxygen to the higher molecules, it will be another set of increasing order of molecular orbitals. So for example, if we consider for nitrogen and lower molecules, means hydrogen to nitrogen, the energy of molecular orbitals will be in this order, like sigma 1 is bonding will be having the lowest energy. Then next highest energy is sigma 1s antibonding molecular orbital, then sigma 2s bonding molecular orbital, and sigma 2s antibonding molecular orbital. And this is the focus, we have to focus here. So pi px and pi py orbitals and bonding molecular orbitals of px and py, they are having the same energy. So these two are the degenerated orbitals. When electrons will be filled, first electrons will be, one electron will be filled in px and py, then only the pairing of electrons will take place, and this is having lower energy than that of the pz orbital for nitrogen and lower molecules. Whereas if we consider the other molecules like oxygen and higher molecules than oxygen, then the pz orbital, sigma pz orbital, is having lower energy than that of the px and py bonding molecular orbital. So this is the difference between the molecular orbitals of different molecules. From hydrogen to nitrogen, the px and the py bonding molecular orbitals are having lower energy than that of the sigma pz orbital. Whereas for oxygen and higher molecules, sigma pz is having the lower energy than that of the px and py bonding molecular orbitals. So So based on these energy levels, the when we are filling the electrons in the molecular orbitals, first electrons will be filled in the lowest energy orbital, means that is bonding orbitals of that particular molecule. Then only the electrons will enter into the antibonding molecular orbitals. Now with the help of the molecular orbital diagrams, we will be able to find out the bond order. The bond order can be defined as the half of the difference between number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbitals minus number of electrons present in the antibonding molecular orbital. So that can be represented as NB minus NA by 2, where NB represents the number of electrons present in the bonding molecular orbitals, whereas NA represents the number of electrons present in the antibonding molecular orbitals. And during the formation of molecule, if for a molecule number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbital is greater than number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbital, then bond order for that molecule will be positive, it is greater than zero. It indicates that a stable form is formed, a stable bond is formed in the molecule. So if NB equals to NA, means the number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbital equals to number of electrons present in the antibonding molecular orbital, for such kind of molecules, bond order will be zero. Then the bond is unstable and that molecule will not exist. So bond order also describes about the strength of the chemical bond. Bond order is directly proportional to the strength of chemical bond. And as the bond order increases, the strength of chemical bond is going to increase. And it also indicates the number of bonds present between two atoms of a molecule. For example, for a molecule, if bond order is 1, which indicates that single bond is present between two atoms of that molecule. And if bond order is 2, indicates that double bond is present between the atoms of a molecule. And if it is 3, it indicates triple bond is present between the two atoms of that particular molecule. So with the help of molecular orbital diagrams, we will be able to find out the bond order, and which gives the significance whether the molecule will exist or not, and whether the bond is having strength or not, that can be described by the bond order calculations. If we consider the molecular orbital energy level diagram for the nitrogen, two nitrogen atoms will combine together to form the nitrogen molecule. And nitrogen atom is having 7 electrons and its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p3. The left side and the right side, whatever we are representing, are the atomic orbitals of the two nitrogen atoms. And the middle orbitals, what we are showing, are the molecular orbitals of the nitrogen molecule. So 1s we have not represented here. The coming to the molecular orbitals, for example, here 1s molecule atomic orbital of two nitrogen atoms will combine to form sigma 1s bonding molecular orbital and sigma 1s antibonding molecular orbital. In the same way, 2s orbital, 2s atomic orbital of two nitrogens will combine to form the 2s sigma bonding molecular orbital and 2s sigma antibonding molecular orbital. And 6p orbitals of two nitrogen atoms will combine to form the 6 molecular orbitals in the nitrogen molecule. They are pi px and pi py bonding molecular orbital, sigma pz bonding molecular orbital, then pi px and pi py antibonding molecular orbital, and pi sigma pz antibonding molecular orbital. So while filling the electrons, it will follow the half Bose rule, means the electrons will be first filled in the sigma 1s bonding molecular orbital. So it will have 1s2, sigma 1s2 electrons. Then the electrons will go to sigma 1s antibonding. So 4 electrons will be filled in the 1s bonding and antibonding molecular orbital. Then the electron will enter into the sigma 2s bonding molecular orbital. Each molecular orbital can accommodate 2 electrons only, and which are having opposite spin. So after filling up of sigma 2s bonding, the electrons will enter into sigma 1s and sigma 2s antibonding molecular orbital. Then up to here 8 electrons will be filled, then the electrons will enter into the pi px bonding and pi py bonding molecular orbital. So as these two are the degenerated molecular orbitals, first single electron will be filled in this. After that, pairing of electrons will take place. Now two more electrons will left with, which will be filled in the sigma pz orbital. So up to this, the electrons will be filled. So up to sigma pz 2 electrons, the nitrogen molecule will have the electrons filled up in the molecular orbitals. So according to the bond order calculation, if we calculate the bond order for the nitrogen molecule, that can be represented as half of the difference between number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbital and number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbital. So number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbital is sigma 1s2, sigma 2s2 and pi px2, pi py2, sigma pz2. So total 10 electrons are present in the bonding molecular orbitals. And coming to the number of electrons present in the antibonding molecular orbitals, sigma 1s2 star and sigma 2s star 2. So total 4 electrons are present in the antibonding molecular orbitals. So we will get the bond order for nitrogen is 3, which indicates triple bond is present between the two nitrogen atoms of the nitrogen molecule. And the nitrogen molecule is highly stable. And with the help of even molecular orbital energy level diagram, we will be able to find out whether the given molecule is the paramagnetic in nature or diamagnetic in nature. If there is unpaired electrons present in the molecular orbitals, then the molecule will be having paramagnetic nature. If no unpaired electrons, means if all the electrons are paired up in the molecular orbitals, then that particular molecule is known to be diamagnetic. So if we consider the nitrogen molecule, all the electrons are filled, completely filled in the molecular orbitals. There are no more unpaired electrons present in the nitrogen molecule. Hence, nitrogen molecule is diamagnetic in nature. And based on the bond order, the nitrogen molecule is having triple bond between the two nitrogen atoms and it is highly stable molecule. In the same way, if we consider the molecular orbital energy level diagram for the oxygen, below oxygen, that is hydrogen to nitrogen, will be having some kind of energy level, increasing order of energy level of molecular orbital, whereas the pattern will be different from oxygen to higher molecules. So if we consider for the molecular oxygen is formed by the combination of two atoms of oxygen, and oxygen is having the atomic number as 8. So oxygen molecules will have 8 plus 8, 16 electrons that will be filled in the different molecular orbitals of oxygen molecule. And when we write the molecular level energy level diagram for the molecular oxygen, here left side we are representing the atomic orbitals of one oxygen atom, and complete right side we are representing the atomic orbitals of another oxygen atom, and in between them we will be having the molecular orbitals of the oxygen molecule. And here this is the energy level order for the molecular oxygen, where the difference between nitrogen and oxygen is, here for the oxygen, sigma pz bonding orbital is having the lower energy than that of the px, pi px and pi py orbitals. So first electrons will be filled in the sigma 1s bonding molecular orbital, then enter into the sigma 1s antibonding molecular orbitals. This 1s will be completely filled. Then the electrons will enter here. The sigma 2s bonding molecular orbital will be filled with the electrons, 2 electrons. Then the electrons will go to sigma 2s antibonding molecular orbitals. Now 2p atomic orbitals of the atomic oxygens will combine to form the 6 molecular orbitals, six molecular orbitals of the p orbitals. So here one is the sigma pz and two are the pi px and pi py, which are degenerated orbitals, and then pi px pi py antibonding molecular orbitals, then finally sigma pz antibonding molecular orbitals. So each p orbital of the oxygen atom is having 4 electrons. 8 electrons will be filled in the molecular orbitals. As when filling in the pi px pi py antibonding molecular orbitals, as these are the degenerated orbitals, first single electron will be filled in the each degenerate orbital, then only pairing will take place. So according to this molecular orbital diagram of oxygen, single electrons are present, unpaired electrons are present in the pi px and pi py antibonding molecular orbitals. So according to this, molecular oxygen is having paramagnetic nature. And coming to the bond order calculation for the molecular oxygen, bond order can be calculated as half of the difference between NB minus NA, number of electrons present in bonding, and minus number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbitals. If you consider that for the molecular oxygen, the number of bonding electrons are sigma 1s2 electrons, sigma 2s2 electrons, and sigma pz2 electrons, sigma px and pi px and pi py 2 electrons. So total 10 electrons are present in the bonding molecular orbitals. Whereas coming to the number of electrons present in antibonding molecular orbitals, sigma star 1s 2 electrons, and sigma 2s star antibonding molecular orbital 2 electrons, and pi px and pi py antibonding molecular orbital each with 2 electrons. So total number of antibonding electrons are 6. So half of 10 minus 6, that will give bonded as 2. Means double bond is present between the two oxygen atoms of the molecular oxygen. And as it is having the unpaired electrons in the pi px and pi py antibonding molecular orbital, molecular oxygen is known to have paramagnetic nature. So this is about the molecular orbital diagram for the oxygen. Similar way, fluorine molecular orbitals also arranged in the same order. The only difference is fluorine atomic number is 9, and molecular fluorine will have total 18 electrons. So after filling up of each electron in the pi px and pi py antibonding molecular orbitals, the pairing also will take place because it is having total 10 electrons in the p orbitals, p atomic orbitals. So this is the electron configuration of the molecular fluorine. And coming to the bond order for the fluorine can be calculated as half of number of bonding electrons minus number of electrons present in the antibonding molecular orbitals. So here 1s is having 2 electrons, 1s antibonding is having 2 electrons, sigma 2s 2 electrons, sigma 2s antibonding 2 electrons, sigma pz 2 electrons, pi px pi py total 4 electrons, and then pi px and pi py antibonding molecular orbitals also with the 4 electrons. So if we calculate number of electrons present in the bonding molecular orbitals is 10 and antibonding molecular orbitals is 8. So half of 10 minus 8 is 1. It indicates bond order is 1 for the fluorine molecule. It indicates that single bond is present between the two fluorine atoms of the fluorine molecule. And if we consider the nature, magnetic nature of the molecular fluorine, it is not having any unpaired electron. All the orbitals are completely filled in the molecular fluorine. So because of 0 unpaired electrons present in the fluorine molecule, that molecule in fluorine is having the diamagnetic property. So this is about the molecular orbital diagram for the fluorine, which is similar with the oxygen. Hydrogen to nitrogen, the molecular orbital increasing order will be in a different pattern. Whereas coming to the oxygen and higher molecules, it will go similarly, and that is different from that of the nitrogen. And coming to the molecular orbital diagram of 1,3-butadiene. 5 molecular orbital diagram of 1,3-butadiene. 1,3-butadiene structure is this one, which is having the 4 carbon atoms and 2 alternate double bonds are present between 1,2 carbons and 3,4 carbons. Each carbon atom is having sp2 hybridized orbitals. One s orbital and 2 p orbitals of the carbon atom will combine to form the sp2 hybridized orbital. And here we'll have 4 carbon atoms with each one having sp2 hybridized orbitals. And along with that, each carbon atom is having one unhybridized p orbital. And each unhybridized p orbital of the carbon atom is having single electron. So 4p unhybridized orbitals are present in the 1,3-butadiene, and each unhybridized p orbital is having one electron. And we can explain the molecular orbital diagram for the 1,3-butadiene by taking a reference as ethylene. For example, if we break the bond between second and third carbon, it will give two ethylene molecules. So we can explain the molecular orbital diagram of the 1,3-butadiene by taking example of the ethylene molecule. And 4p orbitals of the 1,3-butadiene will form 4 molecular orbitals, which can be represented either as pi1, pi2, pi3 and pi4, or psi1, psi2, psi3 and psi4. So coming to the molecular orbital diagram of the 1,3-butadiene, as we have discussed, that we can explain in detail about the molecular orbital diagram of 1,3-butadiene by taking reference as 2 ethylene molecules. So if we consider the pi molecular orbitals of 2 ethylene molecules, they can be represented like this. And during the combination of 2 pi molecular orbitals of ethylene molecules, if the 2 pi molecular orbitals undergo in phase addition, that is positive lobe of 1 pi molecular orbital combined with the positive lobe of another pi molecular orbital, then we will get the molecular orbital as psi1, that is the first molecular orbital for 1,3-butadiene, and which is not having any nodal planes. So this is known as the in phase addition of the pi molecular orbitals of 2 ethylene molecules, which will give psi1 molecular orbital. And if the pi molecular orbital of ethylene molecules will undergo out of phase addition, that is positive lobes of 1 pi molecular orbital combined with the negative lobe of another pi molecular orbital, we will get psi2, and which is having one nodal plane here. The nodal plane is the plane which is having the probability of finding the electron as 0. So 1,3-butadiene is having 4 electrons which will be filled in psi1 and psi2. So this psi2 is known as HOMO, higher occupied molecular orbitals. So pi molecular orbitals of 2 ethylene molecules, if they undergo in phase addition, we will get psi1. And if they undergo out of phase addition, that will form the psi2 with one nodal plane. And coming to the pi antibonding molecular orbital of 1 ethylene molecule undergoes in phase addition of pi antibonding molecular orbital of another ethylene molecule, then here we will get the psi3, which is having two nodal planes. Here between first two orbitals one nodal plane, and between third and fourth orbitals another nodal plane. And this is psi3, which is known as LUMO. LUMO indicates lower unoccupied molecular orbital. And if pi star antibonding molecular orbital of 1 ethylene molecule undergoes combination with the pi antibonding molecular orbital through out of phase, means positive lobe of 1 pi antibonding molecular combines with the pi antibonding molecular orbital, another sign, then it will form out of phase addition, and it will form the psi4 molecular orbital for the 1,3-butadiene. And it is having 3 nodal planes, one between the one and two orbital and the second one between the second and third orbital and the third nodal plane between third and fourth orbital. So these are the different energy level molecular orbitals of 1,3-butadiene. And here we can represent even that with the help of pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 and pi 4 molecular orbitals as ethylene as 1,3-butadiene having 4 electrons present in the 4 p orbitals. So 4 electrons will be accommodated in the first 2 molecular orbitals of the 1,3-butadiene, that is pi 1 and pi 2. Here we can represent that the first molecular orbital, which is indicating that pi molecular orbital of 2 ethylene molecules are undergoing in phase addition, which will form the pi 1 and it is not having any nodal plane. The second molecular orbital of 1,3-butadiene is formed when pi molecular orbital of 1 ethylene molecule undergoes overlapping, out of phase overlapping with the pi molecular orbital of another ethylene molecule. So that will form the pi 2, which is having one nodal plane, and pi 3 is formed by the in phase overlapping of pi antibonding molecular orbital of one ethylene molecule with the pi antibonding molecular orbital of another ethylene molecule. This is in phase addition, which will form two nodal planes here and here. And coming to the last molecular orbital, fourth molecular orbital, which is formed by the pi antibonding molecular orbital of one ethylene molecule, undergoes out of phase addition with the pi antibonding molecular orbital of another ethylene molecule, and it is having three nodal planes. So this is about the molecular orbital diagram of 1,3-butadiene, which can be explained by taking an example of a reference of ethylene molecule. So thank you for watching.